Well, hello, hello. I hope all is well and that you're safe and sound. So today we are going to do another review, and this time it is going to be a full in-depth review of the Aveda Nutriplenish line. So if you would like to know more about this hair care range and would like to have a in-depth product research review, then most definitely keep on watching. So let me first off mention that I am a certified trichologist, which means that I am specialized in everything when it comes to scalp and hair care. And I am low-key a research product ingredient junkie. So yeah, that is all colliding into one today. So like I said, I am going to review the Aveda Nutriplenish line, which I have been using on and off for the next year, I would say. I got introduced by the brand Aveda and this line due to a press trip that I made. I think it was at the end of 2019. So it's a little bit over a year that I was able to try out the whole range. So what I'm going to do is I am going to discuss what Aveda stands for, what this line stands for, and we are going to go through each and every single product of this range. I'm going to tell you what's inside, what you need to know. Maybe there's something weird in it. You're gonna find out. And I am also giving you my personal review after using this on and off for the past year. So let's just get into it. So this was actually the first range of Aveda where they decided to kind of divide the range into two sections or into two customer preferences. So it is the exact same range, but they only divided it into a light version and a rich version. Is it rich? Let me double check. Sorry. It is light and deep. So this range promises you at least 72 hours of full hydration and moisture. And like I said, it's divided into two ranges. I'm mainly going to discuss the deep one. I'm just briefly going to discuss with you what the difference is between the two, but I do have to say that I mostly use the deep moisture one. You get the light moisture and a deep moisture. The biggest difference between the two is there is a higher percentage of the butters inside of the deep moisture one in comparison to the light moisture one. So it does contain the same ingredients, but just a richer formula, so a higher consistency of the rich ingredients in the deep moisture one. If you purchase the range, then it will consist out of four products. It's six due to the difference between the light and the deep, but the specific product is in four. So you get the shampoo. This is the light version, this is the deep version, and that's the only difference. Like you see the color difference with the lighter one, you know it's a lighter formula, and the deeper, richer color stands for the deep one. So you get the shampoo, you get the conditioner, you get their leave-in conditioner, and you get their multi-use or multi-purpose hair oil. A couple of things that are very important to say about Aveda is that their bottles, so all their bottles are 100% recyclable, and these are actually also made out of recycled material. And this actually the first range where they were able to pull off such a bright color using the recycled products. What you see a lot with recycled bottles, so that are made out of recycled material, is that their color kind of is grayish because it is reused product. So the same as I think it's with recycled toilet paper, you will also see that the color of that is different in comparison to your regular toilet paper because they used different materials to get back to that product. I've written everything down, so sometimes you're gonna see me look at my paper. I'm so sorry for that, but I just really wanna make sure that I give you the right information. So I'd rather read it off my notes than tell you the wrong things. The whole range is free from silicones, sulfate cleansers, paraben, gluten, mineral oil, and petrolatum, and it's cruelty-free, vegan, 100% recyclable bottles, 100% wind and solar powered manufacturing, and their ingredients are 90% natural derived hair products. So 90% is naturally derived. That differs per product, but on average, it's 90%. With a lot of their products, it's higher, but they want to be honest, so like in average, it's 90%. Let's start off with the shampoo. The shampoo retails for $35, and it is a 8.5 fluid ounces, or for my Dutchies or for my European people, 250 mils. It says on their website that this is a decadent shampoo with vegan superfood blend of potent plant butter and oils. It cleanses and replenishes dry hair with nutrient-powered hydration. When it comes to the ingredients, the first ingredient is water, which is good. We're always happy with that. Second ingredient is sodium coco oil, and this is a cleansing agent that is derived from coconut, and it is considered to be a mild cleansing detergent agent. So it is very mild on the scalp and the hair. This shampoo, by the way, is sulfate free. So this is the replacement for sulfates, and that is the same to its next ingredient, which is cocoa midipropyl betaine. This is also a cleansing agent. It's almost always used as the second cleansing ingredient because it is a lather booster. So it really helps to give you that lather. And that's also what I feel when I apply it. It really has a nice lather, and this ingredient does that. If you see this ingredient, by the way, as the first cleansing agent, so the first ingredient when it comes to cleansing, chances are really high that it is not as good as a shampoo, a sulfate-free shampoo, because this is such a mild ingredient that it just doesn't really cleanses enough. So it helps to boost or enhance the cleansing ingredient that is before that. But if it is used as the first cleansing ingredient, then chances are really high that you will feel, and especially after a couple of uses, notice that it doesn't get rid of all the buildup. An ingredient that is also very familiar in this range that you will see is propanediol. This is actually a glycol, and this enhances the absorption of other ingredients. So for example, if a product is really meant to add moisture, this will enhance the effect of that moisturizing ingredient. Not only that, it also has hydrating properties. It's a really nice ingredient to see in a shampoo, which 9 out of 10 times can be very stripping. If you hate that feel, this is an ingredient that will really help out with that. Another ingredient that you will see in this whole range is mango seed butter. Now, this is kind of the hero ingredient in this range. And this is also the ingredient that is in less percentages in the light version and more higher up in the deep version. This is a plant-based emollient, and it is a super rich source of fatty acids. It also can be skin soothing. So for the scalp, it really works as a soothing agent, and due to its fatty acids, it also really helps with the elasticity of the scalp. The shampoo also contains an anti-static ingredient, which is coca midipropyl dimethylamine, which you actually also could see as an ingredient in the bread products, and it works as an anti-static, so it will help you with that static effect that your hair could get, and will also help against frizz. It contains pomegranate seed oil, which is also an ingredient that you will see in the whole range. This oil is very rich in antioxidants, so it will really help to protect the hair to outside environment. It contains coconut oil, which is also rich in fatty acids, and an ingredient that I'm very happy with that I see in this one is Avena sativa, which is actually oatmeal. And from a trichology point of view, oatmeal is an ingredient that is very soothing for the scalp and is often used to treat or to soothe a condition called psoriasis. So if you have psoriasis or if you have a very irritated scalp, this ingredient will really help to soothe that. Another ingredient that is very soothing that's in it is lauric acid. This is skin replenishing, so it's good for the scalp, and it's also soothing and a light cleanser. So it really helps with the scalp. So from a trichologist's point of view, I'm really, really impressed with these shampoos. They are really soothing for the scalp, and even though we're talking about hair care, I care a lot about scalp care as well, and this is a very scalp-friendly shampoo that I can definitely recommend. I also notice it while I use it. It's very soothing. The scent is like I find with every Aveda product. It's very herby. You either love it or you hate it. I really love it because it kind of gives me that spa feeling, if that makes any sense. And it is not overpowering. It lathers up like a dream, really nice. It is thick, so if you don't like thick consistencies, this might not be the one for you. But I actually love it because I love to emulsify it in my hand with some water. And that will really help you get rid of that thickness. And a little goes a long way with this one. For a sulfate-free shampoo, because you know I'm not that big of a fan of sulfate-free shampoos to use as the only way to cleanse my scalp, I do like to use this one as my second cleanse. Up next is the conditioner. So when it comes to the conditioner, it is a different design in comparison to the shampoo. It is with this. This is the way you apply. So it's like this. I do like these type of bottles. They really work really well into squeezing a product out. And also, that's with the shampoo. If you run out of it, you need to like toss it forward or do like this. You don't have that with these bottles. I don't even know if this is a bottle. Let me know if it's called differently. Put it in the comment section. This one is the same amount of fluid ounces. It's 8.5, so 250 milliliters. And this one goes for retail for $37. When it comes to the ingredients of the conditioner, one of the first ingredients that you will find next to water and cetearyl alcohol is an ingredient that is called stearimidopropyl dimethylamine. This is a water-soluble natural silicone. So this is used to kind of replace the effect that a silicone has. It helps when it comes to making the hair feel smoother, kind of helps to close down the cuticle, to reflect light. So it functions as the way that a silicone would, but not with that build up sealing effect, if that makes any sense. And it's very easily water soluble, so it's nothing to worry about. You won't have build up with this ingredient. Another ingredient that's in here is behetrimonium chloride. This works as an emulsifier, but if used on the scalp, it can also be very scalp conditioning. Again, it contains multiple oils like coconut, pomegranate, it contains shea butter, it contains the mango seed butter again. So what you will see is a lot of the ingredients in this conditioner help to not only moisturize, but also smooth down. Again, to prevent the frizziness, to make the hair able to reflect more light, which will also result into healthier looking hair, but most importantly, due to the other ingredients, healthier feeling hair. Another one that might scare some people is lactic acid, but like I said multiple times, lactic acid actually has really moisturizing properties. So don't see it as an acid that will pull out something. It really helps to moisturize the hair and scalp. And a funny thing is that they use glycerin way below in the ingredient list. So that is not their biggest thing. They really focus on the nourishing things first. And glycerin, don't get me wrong, is a great ingredient, but it's cheap. What you'll get in this bottle is the rich, more expensive ingredient first, and then the glycerin. When it comes to my experience, I tried out both of them. I do really notice a difference in both of them. Like it also says, this one is really light moisturizing. I would say this is a great one to detangle your hair if you have type 4 hair like I have, but if you really need that extra moisture, this one is the way to go. You can also use this as your deep moisture treatment or your deep conditioner, but I would say I would consider it as a light deep conditioner then. This, it smells amazing. It's very nice and thick and creamy, and I love that about this one. And like I said, the way that you can get the product out of the bottle is amazing. My hair feels buttery soft afterwards, and yeah, I was really impressed when I tried it out the first time, and my thoughts really haven't changed on this product. Up next is kind of an award-winning product, which is their leave-in conditioner. So this is a spray bottle, and this product is 6.7 fluid ounces, 200 mils, and it goes for retail for $37. A little side note, this product is the winner of the 2020 Glamour Beauty Awards for the best pro leave-in conditioner. And not only that, Women's Health Editor's Choice has picked this one out as the best leave-in conditioner for 2020. So this one is award-winning, and I personally do get why. But first things first, the ingredients. The number one ingredient is a water. Then again, you will see the ingredient propionyl, which, like I said, is an ingredient that helps other ingredients to get absorbed better and easier. This leave-in also contains baobab and ginger extract, and these both are very rich in antioxidants and work soothing. So again, this is a product based to protect your hair against the environment. Also contains pomegranate, which is rich in antioxidants, and it contains an ingredient that is called Schondes crispus, if I say that correctly, and that is algae. Algae is super rich in antioxidants. So again, it will help to protect your hair and scalp from outside environments. So when it comes to the sun, when it comes to what's in the air, pollution, you name it, these ingredients really help with that. And I feel like that is what this leave-in conditioner is really made out of. A lot of antioxidants, a lot of soothing ingredients, nourishing ingredients that really help your hair to last, trying to prevent your hair from losing its natural moisture and hydration by protecting it against the outside elements that cause that. Also, a very important ingredient is vitamin E. Now, I don't know if you know, but vitamin E has sun protection properties, which also makes this a UV protecting leave-in conditioner. They also say that it is a heat protector. So like I said, it's really a prep to everything that you do throughout your week. I really love this one. This is actually my second bottle and I'm halfway through, because it's such a lightweight spray leave-in conditioner that I love to use as my first moisture and protection boost before adding a thicker and richer leave-in, which makes me come to the point that no, this is not rich enough for me to last all week when it comes to moisture with my hair type. If you have a type 2 or sometimes even a type 3 hair type, then you might be able to pull it off. I unfortunately am not able to, but I have seen a significant difference when I apply this and afterwards apply my thick leave-in. I just love that it also has UV protection in it without you even noticing it, without any weird other ingredients in it. And that is why I love to use this leave-in conditioner. So yeah, super easy to use, smells amazing, and I do understand why this is an award-winning product. It just goes with everything. Last but not least, we are going to talk about the multi-purpose or multi-use. And I don't know if you can see it, I got the tester. This is the one that I got on my press strip. I got 4 bottles and this is my 3rd one. And if you know me, then you might know that I personally don't like oils that much. I'm sorry, I just don't like oils that much, because a lot of the oils just sit on top of my hair or other ingredients flake, in my opinion. But this one is really, really nice. It really is nice. This multi-use hair oil is 1 fluid ounce, so yeah, It's a tiny one, but a little goes a long way, 30 mils, and the retail price is $45. This is also a award-winning oil. It is the winner of the Women's Health Healthy Hair Award for Best Oil. It is a 100% natural derived formula, and it features a concentrated blend of 5 power oils. It offers multiple uses and delivers nutrient-powered hydration and shine for all hair types. Customizable usage helps restore hydration. I have a thing against oils being used for hydration. The way that I would describe this oil is very nourishing, very softening. That is the best way for me to describe how I have experienced it. And I think that that is why I like it. It doesn't sit up on top of my hair, and it really helps to soften, gives it a natural shine, but not too like fake. And it just smells great. When it comes to the ingredients, it contains sunflower, avocado, jojoba, argan, safflower, coconut, and pomegranate oil. So very high in fatty acids and soothing. And again, it contains also antioxidants. That's actually all that I have to say about this oil. There's not that much to say. If I would recommend an oil, then it would be this one. And yes, it is expensive, but if I compare it to all the other hair oils that I've tried out thus far, I grab this one the most. Honestly, I grab this one the most. So the leave-in conditioner is a lightweight leave-in conditioning spray, and it replenishes hair for 72 hours while detangling and protecting from thermal styling up to 450 Fahrenheit. Natural derived UV filter helps protect the hair from drying effects of the sun. All in all, when it comes to this hairline, I have to be honest, there is nothing weird ingredient wise on it. There is nothing controversial about its ingredients. It's really clean, they're very transparent, and I feel like if you're really into also investing in vegan, recycled, well thought of hair care, then this is a really nice, luxurious hair range to look for. Is it worth the money? I would personally say yes. It really lives up to its expectations, and I think that that is the most important thing about hair care. If something is expensive, I don't mind spending it, but it needs to be worth it. And I have not been disappointed in any of these products, to be super honest. If there's one thing that I would personally invest in, then it would be the hair oil. I know it's super weird that I say that, me investing in a hair oil, but this would be it. If there's one thing that I wouldn't invest in, it would probably be the leave-in, just because I use it as my first out of 2 leave-in conditioners, but I do like it. Difficult. I do think that you get what I mean. So all in all, I am a fan. I'm loving it. I don't have anything negative to say about this brand, to be super honest. And the ingredients as well is really, really, really nice. It does contain, by the way, essential oils. Do I say that right? If you're sensitive to that, that might be the only problem. It is all the way below on the ingredient list, but it is something that I do always need to mention. But other than that, Aveda kind of has my heart a little bit. Yeah, I hope you really, really enjoyed this video. Please let me know if you have any other hair range or hairline suggestions that I need to keep in mind, maybe for the next one. And until then, stay safe, and I will see you in the next video.